If there's one question that has always fascinated me, it's this. How many languages can one speak? Hi, my name is Luca from lucalampariello.com, and today I'm going to talk to you about my personal experience learning 14 languages and even reveal some secrets about the marvelous world of polyglots. So, how many languages is it possible for one person to speak? Well, first of all, I think we need to define our terms. What does it mean to speak a language? To me, to speak a language means being able to speak a language fluently. Okay, Luca, what does fluency mean? Well, to me, fluency in a language means possession of the linguistic ability combined with cultural awareness to smoothly and confidently interact with native speakers in a meaningful way. I think the level B2 of the Common European Framework of Reference for Languages matches the description nicely. By the way, if you want to dive a little bit deeper into fluency and its meaning, I've left a link in the description box to a previous video I've made on the topic. Okay, with this framework in mind, let's delve into the world of polyglots and other so-called super language learners, so we can see just how these extraordinary people managed to achieve so much in the world of languages. There are a lot of famous polyglots throughout history. If you're a language buff, as I am, I'm sure you have heard of the German polyglot Emil Krebs, or the famed interpreter Kato Lomb, or Lomb Kato, as she is known in her native Hungary, just to name a few. But the most famous polyglot of all is probably my Italian countryman, Cardinal Mezzofanti. Giuseppe Gasparo Mezzofanti lived in the last part of the 18th century, and to this day, he's probably considered the most amazing polyglot to ever live. According to various sources, he could speak almost 3 dozen languages with rare excellence and a number of other languages surprisingly well. Some even claimed that he could speak up to 70 languages. Personally, I have no doubt that Mezzofanti was an extraordinary polyglot in person. However, I'm a bit skeptical of big claims, especially when you hear it said that someone used to speak languages perfectly. My skepticism is a result of 2 things that I've learned well over the course of my life. First, no one speaks a language perfectly, not even natives. And second, in order to judge a polyglot, it takes another polyglot. While I'm sure Mezzofanti's skills seemed mind-bogglingly impressive to many, the truth is that there were likely extremely few people who knew enough about all of Mezzofanti's target languages to be able to reliably judge his abilities in each. And that's the reason why it's really difficult to assess whether any historical figure really spoke 20 or 30 languages fluently, or just 1 or 2 languages fluently, and the rest like word salad. So, judging the polyglots of the past is an arduous task, but what about the polyglots of today? Fortunately, nowadays, it is extremely easy to film and analyze people's skills. Though this means that the skills of many polyglots can be recognized and celebrated, it can occasionally have disastrous results when claims of language ability do not align with reality. As an example, in the 90s, there was a man named Ziad Fazah who claimed that he could, and I quote, speak all the languages of the world. Until 1998, the Guinness Book of World Records stated that Fazah could speak and read 58 languages. In 1997, Fazah was invited to Chile to appear on a talk show where he would be able to showcase his impressive language abilities. On set, Fazah was asked 7 questions by natives of the languages he claimed to speak, and he succeeded in successfully answering 1 question and failed the rest. Needless to say, for language fans, those results are not thrilling. The story of Ziad Fazah remains a brutal reminder that there's a big gap between saying you can do something and actually doing it. This is absolutely not to slander Ziad or any other person who claims to speak an exceeding number of languages. I say it just to put things in perspective, to warn you as a language learner to take big claims and even official sources with a grain of salt. Now, does that mean that super polyglots are a myth? No, not at all. Quite the contrary, in fact. Super language learners are real. They are among us, and I've been fortunate enough to meet several of them. In 2008, I posted my first ever YouTube video, a multilingual monologue made from a balcony in Barcelona. A few months later, I stumbled upon a stunning video in which a man named Richard Simcutt spoke a bunch of languages. To see someone with Richard's skills instantly piqued my curiosity and motivated me to reach out. Richard and I eventually became friends, and together we have attended many language learning conferences throughout the globe. We even came up with the initial idea for the Polyglot Conference, which is an annual event that has been held in all parts of the world. I am pretty sure that many of you who are watching this already know Richard. He's a remarkable person with an incredible drive for learning languages. To Richard, every single moment is an opportunity to learn new words and concepts in a language, or two, or ten. As of right now, we share 14 languages between the two of us. Richard's total is around 40, I think. And I can tell you that the way he speaks most of them is indeed remarkable. Around the same time that I met Richard, I also came into contact with another polyglot, a Slovak interpreter by the name of Vladimir Skultete. Vlad also belongs to the category of individuals that see language learning as a life mission, and so he has reached impressive heights in 20 languages. To see Vlad's multilingual viral video, please check in the description box. And then, of course, there is Emanuele Marini, my Italian countryman from Bergamo, whom I had the pleasure to meet during the very first Polyglot conference. Emanuele, like Richard and Vlad, has an enormous thirst and curiosity for foreign languages, and his skills are nothing short of mind-blowing. Shortly after meeting Emanuele for the first time, I recorded a video of him getting interviewed in multiple languages by a grand total of 16 polyglots. If you want to see an impressive multilingual show, click the link to that video down in the description box. You will not regret it. Richard, Vlad, and Emanuele are just three examples of the impact that curiosity, drive, and life circumstances can have on the upper bound of one's language abilities. You can find many more like them, both online and in real life. So rest assured that these are not fairy tales. Hyperpolyglots and other super language learners do really exist. Which takes us back to our initial question. How many languages can one learn? Well, it is estimated that our brain contains as many neurons as there are stars in the Milky Way galaxy, and that there are more connections between those neurons than there are stars in the whole universe. These staggering numbers suggest we have an amazing, incredible capacity to learn truly anything, and that we can do it quickly and efficiently, given the right circumstances. On top of that, modern technology allows for quick movement, communication, and the sharing of ideas. For reference, modern language learning staples like Skype, YouTube, and Netflix did not even exist 20 years ago. So the power of modern technology combined with the power of the human mind can create miracles. While I have no doubts that for future generations, speaking 5 or even 10 languages will be the norm, there are some physical limits that we may not be able to overcome, at least for now. The biggest restrictions on the brain's language learning capacity are space, time, and memory. In fact, even if our brain's capacity to store information were infinite, we as people are not infinite. We're limited in time and space. We can only do so much. We can only learn so much. Let's try a thought experiment. Let's imagine a girl who starts learning languages at the age of 10. This girl is lucky. She's got a family of diplomats and polyglots who travel around the world. For the first 10 years of her life, she moves from country to country. By the time she turns 10, she can speak 10 languages fluently. Then she decides to dedicate her whole life to traveling and language learning, hopping from country to country to reach a grand total of 80 countries. Before moving between countries, she learns a local language for a year so that she can harness her time in country to maximize her skills. Well, by doing the math, we can conclude that by the time she turns 90, she will be speaking around 80 languages fluently. Unfortunately for her and for us, the world of super language learners is riddled with one big problem: language maintenance. The more languages an individual learns, the more they have to practice to avoid forgetting. If you can speak 30 languages, you'll need to practice all of them semi-regularly if you do not want to lose them. A day has only 24 hours, of which we spend around 8-12 sleeping, depending on the individual. And on top of that, there is also the phenomenon of interference. If you ever need to spend lots of time with one language exclusively, others will suffer, and similar languages will start interfering with each other. A polyglot's language skills constantly fluctuate over time. Okay, what are the takeaways from all this? Well, there are quite a few. First, we have to see the glass as half full. We are all capable of learning an incredible amount of languages because we are all in possession of a brain, and the human brain is one of the most powerful objects in the world. Many people do use their powerful brains to learn incredible amounts of languages. These polyglots are known as polyglots, hyperpolyglots, or even super language learners. And they're incredibly passionate people who have amassed amazing language skills through decades of dedication and hard work. Though these people do really exist, it is in your best interest as a learner to take lofty language claims with a grain of salt. Most people who claimed big things in the realm of languages have fallen flat on their faces. Real polyglots are, for the most part, focused, humble individuals who are aware that what they do not know will always exceed what they do know. And in the end, it does not really matter how many languages one speaks. Even knowing one language other than your native one can open doors and transform your world. As Catullombe used to say, language learning is that one thing that is worth being able to do, even poorly. As always, thanks for watching, and if you enjoyed this video, please click on the link in the description box. I've written an extensive article about it. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell for lots more great content to come.